El propósito hoy es de esta conferencia es enseñarlos sobre los peligros de la SIDA 1.3D y más que nada también nuestra presentación de películas hechos por, documentarios más que nada hechos por jóvenes como mí, muchos demás que están aquí con nosotros y también para presentar un documental sobre nuestra organización Safe Ag, Safe Schools y el trabajo que hemos hecho.
¿Por qué tú has visto afectado por los pesticidas? ¿Tú has visto afectado?
Sí, yo estuve en la escuela, tuve 10 años cuando fui afectado por los pesticidas. Yo estuve en la clase como cualquier otro día normal y de repente me encuentro en una ambulancia, en el hospital, peleando por la vida, luchando. Y para mí eso de verdad fue una alarma para decir, no, esto no es justo, no puede pasarle a otros estudiantes, otros jóvenes como yo. Quiero hacer algo, quiero hacer un cambio. Aquí sigo ya desde el 2018 en la lucha y hay muchos momentos bajos que siento uno como que para qué seguir, pero aquí sigo yo luchando con mucha otra gente que sigue luchando y da mucho tiempo para la justicia ambiental y justicia racial, porque es lo que más que nada.
¿Ustedes le piden a lo que radiquen ese químico? ¿Qué es lo que piden? ¿Cuál es la petición? What is the petition that you exact? What are you guys asking for?
Regulation 1.3D.
¿En español?
Regulación sobre 1.3D.
Que lo elimine.
Sí.
We have an amazing painting somewhere here because, like you all know, we have our documentary screening today, which is called Los Nuevos Canarios, right, Megan? Yes. And Rocio is actually holding our art piece done by an amazing artist. CSUMB artist, Diego, let's give him a big round of applause. So this conference not only highlights what we're dealing with pesticides currently right now in our communities, but like you see that canary there as well. Vivimos en una jaula de oro, right? And now with the whole new presidential election and the new president coming into office, this is a fight that we all must be a part of, right?
Right.
Yeah. I can't hear you.
Yeah. Welcome everyone. I am Yaneli Martinez, SAS organizer and Central Coast coordinator for Californians for Pesticide Reform. And for another month, just one more month, I am still a council member for the great city of Greenfield, the heart of the valley. I'm also your MC for today for this 1.3D DPR's Racist Policy News Conference and one of your hosts for a big event happening later tonight. While just a week ago, Governor Newsom announced a special legislative session to plan for the resistance to the upcoming Trump administration, Newsom's own Department of Pesticide Regulation, or known as DPR, has taken a giant leap in the opposite direction. But what's new, right? We all know that was gonna happen. Rather than relying on the latest science, including that of DPR's sister department within CalEPA, the Office of Environmental Health Hazard Assessment, DPR has chosen to protect Dow Chemical's profits. Yes, sadly. Over the health of our communities, our farm working communities that are disproportionately Latino and indigenous. DPR has issued a new draft regulation for the third most used pesticide in the state, 1.3D. The brand name is Telone. That will not protect anyone. Did you all hear me? It will not protect anyone. This is a racist attack on our farmworking communities, but it's coming not yet from Trump, but from our own state institutions. To provide some background information about 1.3D, please help me welcome the State Director of California League of United Latin American Citizens, also known as LULAC, Mr. California State Director Jacob Sandoval.
Good afternoon. It's my pleasure to be here fighting shoulder to shoulder, heart to heart with leaders of state pesticide reform movement. LULAC is dedicated to advancing the civil rights of Latinos across California. As part of the nation's oldest and largest Latino organization, we strive to promote equality, education, and empowerment for all. Woo-hoo! What is 1.3D? A drift-prone fumigant pesticide used to kill organisms in the soil prior to planting. Applied mostly on strawberry and grape fields in the Central Coast and almonds, and walnuts in San Joaquin Valley. Acute harms from an immediate exposure can include irritation of skin, nose, nausea, vomiting, headache, depression, and damage to liver, intestines, and bladder, and difficulty breathing. Long-term exposure to even tiny amounts can lead to cancer. Can you believe that? Lead to cancer. It is seriously harmful stuff. That's why 34 countries have banned it. And even California, where regulations are weak compared to the European Union, many other countries has listed 1,3-D as a Prop 65 carcinogen and toxic air contaminant. Why is 1,3-D applied? Mostly in Latino areas. There are 10 times more pounds of 1,3-D applied in the 11 Latino majority counties than in 25 counties with the smallest Latino proportions. And those two groups have the similar number of total people and acreage. We are right now in Santa Cruz, DPR list 214,549 pounds of 1,3-D applied in 2023. That's an increase of 32% from 2021, and the most since 2017. If DPR won't ban this horrible pesticide, they must at least follow the science, restricting its use. I know our next speaker will address that. Thank you.
Let's give it up for Jacob. Yeah. Thank you, Jacob. Yes, indeed. Our next speaker is the co-director of the Statewide Californians for Pesticide Reform and a graduate of UC Santa Cruz. Yes, if you're still asking yourselves, he is a slug at heart, even though he's in the Central Valley now. Angel Garcia, he is here to talk about the science. Angel, let's give it up.
Thank you, Yanely, and thanks to everyone who made it out this evening. We are really grateful for your ongoing support and coverage of this very important topic. So I want to start off by saying that one of the foundations of public health policy is that it must be driven by, grounded in, health protective science. It should have that at its core. Both the Trump administration in its first term and likely in its second, and also today's California's Department of Pesticide Regulation have done all they can to avoid scientific research. And while we expect that from the incoming administration, that just can't play in the state that prides itself in environmental justice and resistance to Trump. DPR's 1,3-D regulation is an awful example of using legal loopholes and faulty math. I know that numbers can be difficult to digest, so to simplify, let's just consider the following two numbers, 4 and 56. Our state toxicologist at the Office of Environmental Health Hazard, or just simply known as OEHA, in 2022 issued a science-based legal lifetime cancer risk limit for daily exposure to 1,3-D of 4 parts per 100 billion in the air we breathe. OEHA says we get more cancer if the number is above 4. The other number, 56, is the number of parts per billion that 1,3-D's manufacturer, Dow, says could give us more cancer. So at the beginning of this year, DPR implemented a regulation for 1,3-D that applies only to children and residents and not field workers or campesinos. DPR completely ignored OEHA's legal limit of 4 and chose 56 parts per billion instead. So how did they get away with this? Well, they chose bureaucracy over science. Now, let me say that again. They chose for bureaucracy over science. What does that mean? It means that our communities are not being considered whenever they're making and drafting these type of regulations. This is a very concrete example of that. Now, the law only requires the Department of Pesticide Regulation to work on to work with OEHA on regulations when it involves field workers and campesinos. So DPR didn't consult OEHA or even list OEHA's study in its reference list. So that's why DPR went with Dow's number. With today's draft regulation part two for worker bystanders, DPR, now forced by the law and because we took them to the courts, will essentially protect to the 4 parts per billion standard only people who work in the fields from 8 a.m. to 4 p.m. and never also live near 1-3-D applications as children, nor as adults before and after work days, nor in retirement. So basically, what's going on here is that people are just exposed only at work. So if we base it off this logic, that's not gonna be protecting a lot of people. There are very few that actually enter the fields to work them at 8 in the morning. And many of us that have family and no community know that a lot of our community wake up much earlier than that. We do not wake up at 8. We do not stop work at 8. It starts much earlier than that. So children and residents, however, will still be allowed exposure to air with 1,3-D concentrations of 56 parts per billion. Now, DPR has announced no adjustments to that regulation. So it now has two different assumptions about cancer-causing levels within their regulation for the same pesticide. Those are two set of rules for the same pesticide. We're starting to call and we're starting to see as a separate and unequal lifetime cancer risk levels. It's madness. It's appalling. It's racist. Now, there is a simple science-based solution, of course, and that is DPR, you have to limit exposure to 1,3-D for all people living in California to 4 parts per 100 billion. Because at the end of the day, it is imperative that science must drive our regulations and not racist politics. And with that, thank you.
Let's give it up for my boss, Mr. Angel Garcia. Thank you, Angel. Our next speaker is one of the rising young stars of the pesticide reform movement. She's coming after my job, and she's gonna have my job. Rocio Ortiz is a teenager, a field worker, and a co-founder of Future Leaders of Change, and a new CSUMB student. And about, yes, let's give it up for Rocio. And about to debut her first documentary later tonight, so no spoilers. She liked to say some words about what's next in the fight to make science and not racism the basis for environmental policy. Rocio?
Good evening, everybody. I'm Rocio, and I just want to give a little, like, about my opinion, because, like, I am, like, a current, like, farm worker. I have worked in the fields for a couple of summers, and just, like, seeing how this is a very racist, like topic towards, like, farm workers, it just really hurts me, because, like, my parents work in the fields, I have cousins, I have tias, uncles that work in the fields, and it's just like sad to see how my community has been targeted like this. So it's also sad to see that my community is 14 times less protected in this area, and that scientists say it's safe. We are sacrificed for Dow's chemicals profits. If DPR can get away with this, this will be how they regulate all pesticides. We have to stop them. We have to fight back against this attack on farm worker communities. Communities like Watsonville are sacrifice zones for corporate profits. It's got to stop. It really has to stop. And this is why I'm here. This is why I want to be part of the change. If DPR just started a public comment, period on this 13D regulation through January 24th. And it will have in-person 6 p.m. public hearings in Visayla on January 8th and Salinas on January 16th, as well as a Zoom hearing on January 10th, scheduled from 10 a.m. to noon. You must join us if you live here. Salinas is not too far away from here. On January 16th at the Steinbeck Center, speak your mind. Join in protest with your sisters and brothers in the struggle. In this fight, we will continue. If you haven't already, please join Future Leaders of Change, Save Vaccine Schools, or LULAC, chosen to fight, not flight. Today, together, we can do great things. And just yesterday, I actually gave a presentation to my class about 13D, T-Loan, also known as T-Loan. And my classmates were very shocked about all the information I had to give and how it's a chemical that is overly used here in Watsonville and overly used in indigenous communities or communities of color, low-income communities. And they were just very shocked to know that even though if the pesticide isn't like too close to where CSUMB is located, pesticides can still drift from 7 miles away. And it was just very shocking for them. And it's a topic that it's not talked a lot about a lot, but it really should, since it should concern everybody, including consumers. I'll give this back to Yaneli, but thank you everybody for being here.
Let's give it up for Rocio! Yes, I can't hear you. Let's give it up for Rocio! Let's give it up for all the future leaders presentes, Alexia, Camila, Victor, Africa, or Alphas. Todos presentes, a ver, future leaders presentes. SAS members presentes. California for Plasticide Reform presentes. ¿Listos para pelear? Are we ready to fight? We're calling out this racist policy, right? We're gonna tell DPR, you can't hide. Because what? We can see your racist side. DPR, you can't hide. We can see your racist side. DPR, you can't hide.
We can see your racist side.
DPR, you can't hide.
We can see your racist side.
DPR, you can't hide.
We can see your racist side.
And with that, thank you to everyone here tonight for attending today's press conference. DPR, again, you can't hide because we could see your racist side. And so with that, we conclude our news conference. We're open to questions, but please join us for our red carpet and our documentary premiere talking about activism, what you all see here and every single one of these individuals here. ¿Listos para la lucha?
Yeah!
¿Listos para la lucha?
Yeah!
Thank you all.
Timeline question. Yeah. This is a draft to propose very high levels that match Dow's, you know, suggestions of what is allowable and what is not against OEA scientists. What should we as reporters be looking for in terms of, like, after the draft? I know I have your name written down, but the young activist leader did an amazing presentation, but you announced, like, public hearings that were coming up. What's up next, closest to right now?
And I would go back to what Rocio closed with, and that is, you know, if people can join these organizations that are pushing for change, that's certainly something you can do between now and January 16th, when the DPR comes to Salinas. As far as there will be a online Zoom meeting or two that the Department of Pesticide Regulation holds, and I think they're still setting those dates for December, that they're going to have some other, I think it's called the Pesticide Registration and Education Committee or something like that, PREC, on December 12th. But that's, yeah, that's a small piece of what's happening.
And then one quick follow-up to that.
Yep.
What's like the timeline that they're looking to finalize this?
August 2025.
Got it, okay.
Yeah, is when they're planning to present their final version, and that would then become law, I believe, in January of 2026.
Buenas noches. Buenas noches. Bienvenidos a este programa especial, el estreno de las películas Líderes del Cambio. Welcome everyone to this very special screening, the premiere of the film Leading Change. Un aplauso muy fuerte para todos los filmmakers que están presentando su película. Big round of applause for the filmmakers presenting their films tonight. These seven documentary films that you will see tonight are made by the community, about the community, farm workers protecting themselves and protecting the environment. Estas siete películas que van a ver son sobre comunidades campesinas y están hechos por miembros de la comunidad campesina y presentan el trabajo que ellos hacen defendiéndose a sí mismos y defendiendo el medio ambiente. Un aplauso muy fuerte para todos ustedes. It's an honor for the Watsonville Film Festival to present these films tonight. My name is Consuelo Alba. I am the executive director, and I really thank you for being here tonight. Yes. Es un honor para el Festival de Cine de Watsonville presentar estas películas. Es un estreno mundial. Y estamos muy contentos en nombre del equipo, de mí misma, Consuelo Alba, soy la directora del festival, y es un honor tener estas películas aquí en nuestra comunidad. Durante 12 años, el Festival de Cine de Watsonville ha presentado cineastas latinos e indígenas que hablan de las historias de nuestra comunidad. Estas historias casi nunca se ven en los medios, casi nunca se ven en las películas de Hollywood. Por eso es muy importante crear este espacio para que la comunidad se vea reflejada a sí misma. For 12 years, the Watsonville Film Festival has presented films made by indigenous and Latino filmmakers. And this is really important because we have very, very rarely we see these kind of films on mainstream media. Hollywood doesn't produce films like this. This is why it's so important for us as a community to create this space where we can see ourselves reflected. And this is especially important during these times. As a festival, we are reaffirming our commitment to make the festival visible through films and through storytelling. And we are going to need each other more than ever. Como Festival de Cine es muy importante crear un espacio donde podemos ver películas como estas, hechas por la comunidad que hablen de los temas y de los problemas y las soluciones que podemos tener y que otras no se ven estas historias, estas películas en ningún otro lugar. Cuando ustedes prenden la tele, cuando ven todas estas plataformas de streaming, películas de Hollywood, nadie habla de estos temas. Así es que es muy importante para nosotros apoyar a los cineastas, compartir estas historias para que se dé a conocer la verdad de nuestras comunidades. Estos son tiempos muy difíciles. Nuestro corazón y nuestra mente está con las comunidades que representamos, que están aquí de muchos lugares y que tenemos que trabajar más que nunca para reflejar nuestra realidad y luchar por los derechos de todos, por la dignidad y el respeto de todos los miembros de nuestra comunidad. Así es que les voy a presentar a una amiga muy querida que es parte de este proyecto. Es un proyecto muy especial. Now it's my pleasure to introduce a dear friend. We started working together recently, but I just admire her so much for her work. And it's a pleasure and an honor to introduce Nayeli Martinez. She's amazing work and inspiring lots of people across the region. Es un honor para mí presentar a Nayeli Martinez, que es una amiga que nos conocimos hace poco, pero admiro muchísimo su trabajo y mi respeto por toda la gran labor que haces a un nivel increíble regional, y que por eso estamos aquí todos reunidos. Un aplauso para Nayeli.
¿Cómo estamos esta noche? No escuché. Aquí tenemos que estar un cuarto de activistas. ¿Cómo estamos? That might need the English translation. I was asking all these amazing activists, how are we doing tonight? I didn't feel that energy. How are we doing tonight? I want to hear a loud shout out from all our SAS members. SAS presente. Otra vez, SAS presente. Literally, Consuelo has said some amazing words about me, but my job wouldn't be possible if it wasn't for every single one of the SAS members here. SAS members, raise your hand. A lot, yes, and the newer ones, Brenda, I'm looking at you. They are truly the heart of the movement, they are. And I also want to give a huge shout out to our amazing CPR team. CPR presente! I see my supervisor, Mark Weller, my boss, Jane Sellen, up there. And also, this wouldn't be possible. We wouldn't have this grant without Jackie from the Monterey Arts Council. So can we give her a huge shout out? Jackie, stand up. Stand up, Jackie, so we can all see you, your beautiful face.
All right, Jackie.
We started with a goal, a hope that we were going to create a film about our movement as activists fighting for environmental justice, right? Fighting against racist policies. But it went beyond that. Brenda and her amazing team were able to inspire the next generation of filmmakers with our SAS members, with our future leaders of change, and you are going to see their amazing films, and they're going to tell you it wasn't easy. For me, it wasn't easy being there, supervising everything, but I truly hope that when you leave tonight, you leave with the call to action to join us January 16th in Salinas for the DPR hearing to call out DPR on their racist policy because they're poisoning our communities with 1-3-D, right?
Yeah.
So what are we gonna do?
Fight.
Oh, I didn't really hear you guys like you want to fight. What are we going to do?
Fight.
Louder. What are we going to do?
Fight.
¿Qué vamos a hacer?
Yeah.
¿Se va a poder o no se va a poder?
Sí, se puede.
¿Y dónde está Juan Manuel con la Unión de Campesinos y Bonita? ¿Se puede o no se puede?
Sí, se puede.
No los escucho, compañeros. ¿Se puede o no se puede?
Sí, se puede.
Un aplauso para todos ustedes.
Thank you for that introduction and for that energy. There's really not a lot more to say than just like gratitude for this beautiful journey. This, as Janeri was saying, this was made possible because of a grant that put together nonprofits in the region with local artists. No hay mucho más que pueda decir al respecto que no hayan dicho mis hermosas colegas, sino que, pues sí, este proyecto fue gracias a un apoyo que se dio para que organizaciones sin fines de lucro de la región trabajaran con artistas locales. And thanks to those initiatives, it's not just supporting one nonprofit or one artist. It really goes a long way. The films you're about to watch, the projects you're about to watch, are the collaboration of many local artists. You know, my co-director, producer, Megan Martinez is right here. Este tipo de apoyos no son solamente para un artista o para una organización, son realmente para apoyar a toda una comunidad. Estos proyectos que van a ver es un resultado de trabajo de muchísima gente de aquí, de la región. Y otra vez le damos un shout-out a mi colaboradora, codirectora y productora Megan Martínez. Otra vez. Los Nuevos Canarios, que es la película que van a ver al final, en el cual también participaron otros artistas con cinematografía, con postproducción, con mezcla de sonido, con apoyo moral y con talento, con consejos, con muchísimas otras cosas. And also there's a lot of people here or that couldn't be here, but are also local artists that participated doing cinematography and post-production support, moral support, all types of support, and just their creative, beautiful spirits. También durante el proceso conocimos a otra cineasta, Emma García, que está por acá. Emma, Emma creció en la región, se graduó de Berkeley con su tesis. Y ella pues también se interesó, porque aquí nos interesa una historia tan bonita como la que, lo que está pasando en la comunidad con SAS, y empezó a hacer su proyecto de tesis, y así fue como conectamos con Emma, quien nos dio un apoyo tremendo para crear un proyecto para los cineastas emergentes de SAS. Raise your hand if you're one of the emerging filmmakers from SAS. ¿Dónde están los cineastas emergentes?
¡Los jóvenes!
Donde ellos cuentan sus propias historias desde sus perspectivas. And just lastly, during this process, we also connected with Emma García, who just graduated from Berkeley. This is, and we're going to show her thesis film. Emma, can you wave again?
Emma!
Emma was also very interested in the stories that were happening in the region, and because they're just so absolutely amazing and awe-inspiring. So as she was completing her thesis film, we connected with her, and together we co-created this initiative to have a program for emerging filmmakers and for SAS members to tell their own stories, which are the films you're about to watch. So without further ado, I know we're all waiting for these films. Thank you for being here. Y ya sin más que decir, aquí les presentamos las películas, que las disfruten mucho y bienvenidos.
Los cineastas, por favor, pasen al frente para hacer la sesión de preguntas y respuestas. Wow, beautiful film, powerful, powerful film. Thank you so much. Al frente, por favor, un aplauso bien grande para todos. Todos estos son los cineastas de nuestra comunidad. ¡Qué orgullo! Amazing, beautiful, beautiful, powerful, brave filmmakers and activists. Thank you so, so much for sharing your work and your passion with us. Muchísimas gracias por compartir su trabajo, su pasión y su valor con todos nosotros. Y ahora voy a hacer dos preguntas a cada uno de ustedes. Tenemos 10 cineastas con nosotros y después ustedes van a tener la oportunidad de hacer preguntas. So I'm going to start with two questions for each one of the filmmakers here. And then you'll have the opportunity to ask questions directly to each one of them. Okay, so the first question is, what did you learn making this film? So who wants to start, that side or that side? Okay, la pregunta fue, ¿qué es lo que aprendiste haciendo esta película? Y es una pregunta para cada uno de ellos. Y si puedes decir tu nombre y el nombre de tu película. So please share your name and the name of your film.
Hello everyone, my name is Santiago Torres Martinez. I'm a co-founder of the Future Leaders of Change, and my film was The Story of Us by me and Victor Torres. And for the question, can I have some context to it, please?
Yes, what did you learn making this film? Because when you make a film, you have to think, what's the most important story I want to tell, and how I'm going to tell it, and what the process of making it, right? Entonces, me pregunta que le dé un poco de contexto sobre la pregunta. Le digo que cuando se hace una película, primero se tiene que pensar qué quiero decir, después cómo lo voy a decir, y hay todo un proceso creativo, y mi pregunta es, ¿qué aprendió durante ese proceso?
Well, I definitely learned a lot of filming techniques from my teachers. I've also learned the audio lessons and all that, but my context behind my film and why I chose it was because since a young age I really loved playing soccer, and most of the time you guys would catch me out by the fields, and at a young age I didn't know at the time that being out there for so long was putting my health at risk with all these dangerous chemicals they were applying, and I stated that in the film. And some other things I learned about filming was you really have to choose a story or a good motive that's going to keep your audience entertained with it and keep them, you know, wanting to watch it. You also got to add a little bit of comedy, but I didn't.
But, thank you. Thank you so much. And then, Brenda.
I don't think I have enough time to share what I learned from making this film, but, you know, just basically, it was, from the get-go, it was just listening, spending time, just hearing stories, and just, just kind of giving kind of space for things to emerge, and honestly, like, it's just such a, it's such an honor and such a privilege to be now a part of SAS for life. Learning from all that they do, and yeah, just thank you for all that you all share with us.
Y ahora en español.
Ay, perdón. No, pues lo que decía es que realmente es un proceso. No hay suficiente tiempo para decir todo lo que aprendí. De verdad, como vieron, hay tanto que aprender del trabajo que hace SAS, de lo que hace la región, y desde el principio fue estar allí, observar, pasar tiempo y dejar que las cosas pues se revelaran, y es un trabajo enorme. Es solo el principio de ser parte de SAS ahora por siempre y seguir aprendiendo, porque no va a parar. Gracias.
Ok, mi español ahorita no está muy bien, pero lo voy a tratar. La pregunta era qué era mi motivo también, qué eran unas cosas que...
¿Qué aprendiste que aprendí haciendo esta película?
Haciendo esta película, muchas cosas que aprendí es paciencia, ¿así lo dices?
Paciencia.
Paciencia para hacer la película y también para grabar todos los videos que grabé. Y como les dije, mi motivo era que cuando, desde que era pequeño, un morrito, siempre todo el rato estaba ahí en los files jugando fútbol, y al tiempo, a ese tiempo no sabía que había muchos peligros estando todo ese rato ahí en los files con todos los químicos que estaban sprayando.
Gracias.
My name is Emma Garcia, and I did Fighting to Breathe. And I think the one thing I learned while making this film is just really just the movement that's happening here, not on the Central Coast especially, and especially with our youth. I think we think like youth are making TikTok somewhere and doing something random, but youth on the Central Coast are fighting, and they were, you know, spearheading and being very passionate, trying to get this bill passed, and they did it. And so I think that's something that I didn't know until I started working with Yaneli and SAS, and Future Leaders in Change. So, yeah.
Español, Emma.
Yeah.
Okay, voy a hacer una pequeña síntesis de lo que dijo Emma, que ella lo que aprendió haciendo esta película es sobre el movimiento que existe con SAS, con los jóvenes principalmente en la región de la costa central de California, que es súper inspirador y que ella aprendió mucho de este movimiento, no sabía que existía, y todo el trabajo para que pasara la legislación.
¡Bravo, Emma!
Hello, my name is Alexia Natividad Rangel, and I did Mujeres Activistas Juntas en la Lucha. What I learned making this film is having a lot of patience, like how Santiago said, and editing all of it. And the motive of showing my culture and being part of Future Leaders of Change, I just wanted to show how passionate I am being part of the movement and also showing my culture, like being in like Mexican is like really important to me because I feel like a lot of people should know like the culture and the dances and also just like the community of it. So mi motivo para enseñar de mi película, de mi cultura y de parte de mi familia y líderes del cambio, es porque quiero enseñar mi cultura de mi familia y también cómo estoy apasionada. Y también haciendo esta película me enseñó mucha paciencia para editar y poner muchas fotos y también haciendo película más corto.
Gracias.
Hola, me llamo Noemí Chico y yo hice Mujeres Activistas Mi Legacía. Yo, mi motivo de hacer esto fue como un homenaje a mis papás. Mi papá era miembro de la Unión de Campesinos y mi mamá de Teamsters. Yo y mi hermana somos miembros de la Unión por parte de la escuela. Y pues también, como dijo mi hija, como somos partes de Safe Act, Safe Schools, ella es co-founder de Future Leaders of Change y quisimos demostrar cómo las mujeres tenemos voz. Como estamos juntas en la lucha, ¿verdad? Aquí luchando contra los pesticidas. So my name is Noemí Chico, and what I was like trying to convey was how my parents, my dad was from the United Farm Workers, my mom from Teamsters, myself and my sister are from the union from school, CSEA, and my daughter, we're both in SAS and in this pesticide movement, and that as women we have voice. So that's like part of my legacy, mi legacia. Thank you.
Buenas noches a todos. Yo soy Rocío Ortiz Rivera. Out of context, I just wanted to give a shout out to Yaneli because she organized this whole event, and thanks to her, we are here. Le quería dar las gracias a Yaneli. Gracias a ella pudimos tener este evento porque ella lo organizó. Pero sí, para contestar la pregunta, ¿qué fue lo que aprendí yo de mi documental, The Fair Pay, El Pago Justo? Fue que nosotros los agrícolas, los trabajadores del campo, contribuimos mucho a la sociedad más de lo que pensamos. Como lo mencioné en mi documental, solo en California, las personas indocumentadas contribuyen a 8.5 billones de dólares a la sociedad como pagando sus taxes. Y eso fue algo muy que me sorprendió bastante porque yo dije, los trabajadores agrícolas, ellos se esfuerzan bastante de sol a sol, temprano en la mañana, en el frío, afuera, está heladísimo durante ese tiempo, pero así ellos salen afuera al trabajo. Y yo soy muy agradecida por todo el esfuerzo que mis padres han hecho, porque yo esté aquí dando todo de mí y a contribuir para mi comunidad, porque para mí eso es muy importante. Something that I learned about my documentary, The Fair Pay, is that us agricultural workers contribute to so much more than what we think in society. Paying over, just in California, paying over $8.5 billion in taxes. And it shocked me that not a lot of benefits go towards agricultural workers, and they benefit America in such a great, with a lot of the economy. And I'm just very thankful for my parents, because they have been such an inspiration to me, and just to continue fighting for my community. And thank you to everybody for being here.
Good evening, everyone. And before I continue answering the question, just like Rocio, I wanted to give a huge shout out and thank you to Yanely Martinez for helping organize this event. We couldn't have been here tonight without her. But to answer the question, what did I learn during the whole process of making a film with my brother, which was the story of us? My name is Victor Torres. I am a co-founder of Future Leaders of Change, and I learned many things throughout the process of making this film. One of the biggest ones, as many of my peers just said, was patience. Editing is not for the faint of heart, honestly. But more importantly, I learned the importance of being able to tell your own story. Being able to present your story as to who you really are. Being able to shed light on issues that might affect your community, yourself, or anything that really interests you. The importance of being able to put your voice out there and having the opportunity to do so is really amazing. So, para responder a esta pregunta que me... sobre lo que aprendí en el proceso de hacer mi película, y perdón, mi español es medio pocho. Aprendí muchas cosas, como dijeron muchos de los otros jóvenes aquí conmigo, que la paciencia es algo muy importante, algo que aprendí yo, porque estar editando con una computadora para mí fue algo muy frustrante, pero al fin del día un logro muy importante, porque lo que aprendí más que nada fue, es muy importante poder presentar tu historia como tú ves, que sea lo mejor que puedas. No importa si no te gustó el video, cómo sale tu voz, lo importante es que puedas presentar tu historia como te dé tu gusto, porque todos, teniendo la oportunidad, es importante que todos podamos compartir nuestra historia.
Bravo. Hola, mi nombre es África Torres Martínez, y yo soy el grupo que es The Change. And one thing I learned about this, the film, thank you guys, one thing I learned was that making a film is not that easy, because you have to go through steps and you have to make sure that like your camera is set up well. It's not really easy to make a film, because like really it's hard. It's like you have to put like your camera like in the right direction, and the person that you're focusing on, like they can be moving, and like you want to have them to sit still so you can like have a good like position of your film. And you also want to have like a good angle, yeah. But it's also not that easy at all.
Lo que aprendió África, sí, es que no es fácil hacer una película. Sí, tienen que pensar en el ángulo, en que la cámara esté bien enfocada, porque no es nada fácil solamente presentarse y empezar a filmar. ¿Sí?
Hola.
Hola, me llamo Camila Torres y yo... Okay, I want to speak a little Spanglish, so please. I was working with África in the film called Sueño Americano. And what I learned is, first off, in film class, it's not easy. There's many steps. Like, at some point, Emma, I'm so sorry, I almost fell asleep in your class. So much steps. And also, I learned about new things about my grandpa, because I only knew a little bit like about my grandma and stuff, but then I learned more. Like how, like, or what age he came over here, when did he retire? Like, it was, for me, at some point I wanted to cry, but I was like, it's like, no, just like, you know, keep it to yourself, because like, I'm not a person to cry like in front of everyone, so I just like keep it to myself. But I'm just like happy for that. And I'm happy to see my film. So now it's in Spanish. Some of it's gonna be like a little no sabo. So que aprendí es uno de la clase de film, sorry. Que hay muchos pasos para tener la I don't know. But, yeah, that. Y yo aprendí muchas cosas de mi abuelito, como a cuál año tenía cuando. Sí. Yeah. Basically, all that, but that's all I learned. And that's all I learned.
Hi everyone, thank you so much everybody for coming out. I learned a lot of things making this project with Brenda as well, Los Nuevos Canarios, and I think the biggest lesson I learned was that sometimes when you fight for your family, you have to fight as a family. And it was really beautiful to see Yaneli and Isabel and everybody like coming together and like really prioritizing family. And not just the family we're born into, but the family that we choose to create. Mm-hmm. Yeah. So that was really powerful. Thank you.
Vamos, Meghe.
Gracias, Yaneli. Cuando tú quieres proteger su familia, a veces necesita
luchar.
Hacer con la. Hacer como una familia. Sí, los
The second question is, what do you want people to take away from your film? La pregunta es, ¿qué quieren que la gente se lleve de su película después de verla?
I want them to take away from my film that to be grateful and be thankful for what you have, because I know some of like these people in the audience, some of their parents and grandparents come from Mexico and they immigrate over here to get a better life, but sadly it's not, because they have to work in the fields and they have to sacrifice their lives to like give a good life to their children. That's what I want them to take away from the film. Quiero que aprendan de esta película que los padres y los
abuelos
que vinieron a este país para ganar una nueva vida y sacrificaron sus vidas para los niños, para dar una buena vida.
When you guys leave this theater, I want you guys to remember the American dream is that it never begins. It was never an American dream. It's like a light switch. You turn it on, but then it turns off because your American dream hasn't become true and it's ended there.
Okay, lo que quiere África que la gente se lleve cuando ven su película de El Sueño Americano es que a veces eso no pasa y que es como un switch de prender y apagar la luz y que la gente lo quiere prender la luz, pero de hecho se apaga.
So, regarding what I want people to take from me and my brother's film that they just saw today, two things actually. One of them being that despite all this work that you see many of us up here do, we're going up to Sacramento, speaking with people, feeling intimidated, at least me personally, being in front of so many people or regarding these topics, that at the end of the day, we're still human beings. You see us doing things such as playing soccer, enjoying time out in the city, hanging out with friends. But most importantly, also just to really the level of hidden danger that these pesticides and many other things in our communities pose to us. Like my brother pointed out, playing soccer is something that he's always admired, always done, but never really thought of it as something that threatened his life. In my case, going to school, I never thought of that being something that threatened my life until I was rushed to the ER. So that's what I really want a lot of people to take from this today, is to understand the level of hidden danger that these chemicals provide, or pose to our communities actually, and to really take it as a call to action to want to fight against these injustices, because our communities should not be having to endure these conditions. Many people should not be having to wake up and being with their kids and still having that thought in their mind of, is this the last time I see them? That is not what should be happening.
Okay. Okay, una traducción breve es que quiere que después de que vean su película, que lo vean, que sí va y presenta y se expresa en frente de todos los legisladores, representantes de empresas, pero a fin de cuentas son jóvenes, son seres humanos que tienen una vida, que van a la escuela, que juegan fútbol, y que esto no debería pasar en nuestras comunidades, que el riesgo y el peligro de los pesticidas es algo que se tiene que tomar muy en serio y que se tiene que combatir y cambiar.
My main purpose of making this film was for the viewers to take how much agricultural workers sacrifice to be able to sustain their families, getting exposed to all these chemicals, freezing mornings. Is algo que fue mi propósito para hacer este documental fue que los trabajadores agrícolas están expuestos a muchos peligros afuera en los files, y a veces no son apreciados suficientemente, y es algo que quiero que todos nosotros podamos entender, que es muy difícil estar allá afuera, estar bajo el sol, bajo temperaturas que son muy, muy frías, lejos de nuestra familia, porque yo recuerdo cuando era una niña chiquita, mis padres se levantaban desde las 5 de la mañana y no regresaban hasta las 5 o 6 de la tarde. Y yo pasaba mucho tiempo sin ellos, y yo decía, mis papás tal vez no me quieren, no quieren estar conmigo. Pero después cuando entendí, cuando fui creciendo y me tocó experimentar o me tocó experienciar trabajar en los files, fue cuando dije, mis papás sacrificaron su vida cruzando la frontera para poder darme ese futuro que yo tengo ahora. Something that I also want to mention is that my parents also sacrificed a lot, and they have been such a great inspiration for making this film. Just because when I was a little girl, they would wake up from 5 in the morning to 5 p.m. Sometimes I won't see them until 6 p.m. And I'll be saying to myself, maybe my parents don't want to see me. They don't want to be with me. But then, like, as I got older, I realized, as I got older and had to work in the fields myself, I noticed how much sacrifice they actually were willing to make for my family, for my siblings, for us to have a better future. And it's just such a great blessing that my parents have taught me to be such a, just to value everything I have. And I'm really grateful that they gave me that experience.
Yo lo que quiero que las personas aprendan de el documental fue de que, pues, que aprecien a sus papás, porque así como muchos de mis compañeros, sus papás vienen de México, y pues mis papás estuvieron mucho tiempo en el campo, y pues los peligros de los pesticidas que los afectan a ellos, también a los hijos. A mí me encanta mucho la historia, me gusta mucho hablar y preguntarles a ellos. Supe mucho de la historia de cómo emigraron y todo, pero quise que estuviera plasmado para que sepan que es muy importante, los hijos, los jóvenes, que conozcan esa historia de sus padres, los sacrificios que hacen Estoy muy orgullosa de mis padres. Y ahora de mi hija, que también estamos juntos en la lucha de los pesticidas, que los jóvenes sepan que estén orgullosos de los sacrificios de sus padres, que no porque ellos sean jóvenes no pueden hacer la lucha, están demostrándolos aquí ahorita. So what I want the takeaway of my film is that the children know the history. Like my parents came from Mexico, they worked in the fields for a long time. For them to know how the sacrifices that they're being exposed with pesticides, how the youth make change, like right now, the youth here, they need to be grateful, they need to learn their history and be proud of it. Thank you.
What I would like for you guys to take from my film is to always be passionate from where you come from. Don't ever feel embarrassed by it. Be proud of it. Speak out about it and about any injustices that you guys see and feel. And also learning about more of the environmental racism. Lo que quiero que ustedes aprendan de mi película es de ser apasionados de donde naciste o de tu raíz. Y también para luchar de lo que piensas que es injusticia.
I think something that I would want the audience to take away from the film is just it can be really depressing to know that all these toxic chemicals are in our air and we breathe them every day, and it's right by where we live, right by where we play, right by where we go to school and live. But there are people that are trying to make a difference and they're being successful at doing it, especially when it comes to the next generation, like the youth that are here today. And with that being said, like really knowing that there is people that are trying to do something about it and to support them. And especially when it comes from our youth, when they don't have to be doing this, they could be making TikTok, they could be watching TV, they could be doing right. Anything but fighting for their community, but they're choosing to fight for it. So supporting them is what I really would want you all to get from the film.
Lo que quiere Emma que la audiencia se lleve después de ver la película es que piensen que puede sentirse y pensarse que después de ver la película pues es deprimente saber que los pesticidas están en el aire, que están siempre presentes alrededor de las escuelas, de las casas, y que es un problema tan grande. Pero lo más importante es también darse cuenta que hay mucha gente que está peleando para que eso cambie. Entonces eso es lo que nos debe dar esperanza, y cuando veamos esto es en saber qué están haciendo, en qué están trabajando y apoyar, ¿verdad? Apoyar para que esto siga, se han logrado muchos avances, pero todavía falta más y se requiere que la gente participe y apoye.
On that note, which is a perfect note, I do want all of those things to happen and more. And here's a way to support. A lot of you got this little card. It is seed paper, which means if you look at, there's on one side, you will see that the instructions at the bottom. But wait, before you plant it, go to the QR code, scan it, and then this will take you to, it has instructions. Basically, you scroll down, you find to find Californians for Pesticide Reform, which is like the mother organization of SAS. And you click there on donate, and then you put in a little note that says SAS donation. And then you you get a little pot of dirt, and then you soak this little card overnight, and then you plant it about like, I think, a quarter of an inch, and then you take care of it. And then you literally like plant a seed
of change, but you also put money and you really continue to plan, you know, just grow beautiful things together. Bueno, nada más para seguir, poquito, a little corny, I know. But I had to. Y para seguir con todo lo que estaban diciendo, especialmente lo que dijo Emma, y quiero que todo eso se vuelva realidad y mucho más, lo que han dicho. Pero para apoyar, les acabamos de repartir unas tarjetitas que están hechas. Este papelito es papel de semilla. Entonces, cuando tú lo plantas, crecen cosas bonitas. Pero además, cuando tú donas, en el código QR también crecen cosas bonitas, porque aquí vienen las instrucciones, y disculpen que es que no nos caben en español, pero yo les voy a decir, vas al QR como si tomaras una foto, te va a salir ahí una liga para que vayas en tu buscador, le das clic ahí, y te va a llevar a la página donde vas a ir hacia abajo y vas a buscar Californians for Pests and Reform, lo que dice en el número 2. Ahí le das clic en donar. Cualquier cosa que puedan dar, se agradece mucho para que directamente vaya a SAS. Tú le pones ahí SAS Donation, donativo para SAS. Y entonces agarras y las instrucciones de aquí abajo es básicamente pones, dejas esto remojando en la noche, así en agüita. Preparas tu tierrita y luego ya a la mañana siguiente lo plantas como medio centímetro más o menos. Y le pones la tierrita y lo cuidas mucho. Y ya tendrás, sembrarás cosas muy bonitas.
Hi, so what I want all of you to take away from my film and Victor's film is two things. The first thing is that I want all of you guys to understand that you guys have a very strong power inside of you, and that is your voice, and you guys have to use that power, especially when things are wrong. The second thing is that sadly, life is all about time, and as you grow older, you'll understand that there's so many hardships, especially understanding that there's so many challenges, even when it's something like doing something you're passionate about, such as for me, is playing soccer, and that's what I want you guys to take away from my film. Please
come forward. You are a very wise young man. Un joven muy sabio que quiere que las personas que vean su película se den cuenta que tienen un poder muy, muy grande dentro de sí mismos, y que es nuestra voz. Y que hay que usar ese poder y esa voz para hablar por lo que es justo y para seguir con la lucha, ¿verdad? Y que hay poco tiempo para hacer esto. Es el momento ahora. Así es que él quiere que esta película los inspire a que haya acción y se hagan cosas positivas en nuestra comunidad. Y ahora vamos a tomar preguntas de la audiencia. Por favor, levanten su mano. Tenemos un micrófono por ahí. Now we're going to take questions from the audience. And we have a mic here. Unless you can project really well your voice.
Mi pregunta es para los que están en la high school, si van a entregar esta actividad como parte de su Seal of Civic Engagement para los distritos que participan.
Y ahora en inglés, por favor.
If you're a high school student, will you be submitting this for the Seal of Civic Engagement for your high school diplomas?
That's a great idea.
First off, sadly, I didn't know that was a thing, so I'm not here for my Seal of Civic engagement, so I'm just here volunteering my time for doing something that I deem is right.
Yeah, sadly, me too, I didn't know what that was, but if there is one in Greenfield, I would love to submit it.
I also joined the group. I didn't know that was a thing, but we are happy to make that happen and support. Let's coordinate for that to happen, for sure. Yeah.
Good evening. My name is Jorge Hernandez with the Community Foundation for Monterey County. I really commend the work. As a Center Pop workers, it was great to see your films, and so it means a lot. So I'll provide some context to my question. Is, you know, through your organizing work and the movement building that you've seen many roles. Like in government, you see senators, you see assembly, you see biologists, you see environmentalists. Like, what role do you see yourself playing in the movement in 10 years? Okay. So, buenas noches, mi nombre es Joel Hernández con la Fundación Comunitaria del Condado de Monterrey. Me dio mucho gusto ver cada una de las películas de ustedes como hijo de trabajadores del campo. Me trajo muchos recuerdos, pero también proyecta lo que pasa en los campos. Durante el movimiento y el organizar que están haciendo, ustedes miraron varios papeles que se juegan en esa parte. Senadores, biólogos, organizadores. So, mi pregunta para ustedes, en 10 años, ¿qué rol se miran ustedes tomando en ese movimiento?
In 10 years, I see myself in my mom's position. Oh, and before we continue, Fatima, can you pick up my grandma's poster so that I can see it?
Perdón, nada más traduciendo lo que acaba de decir África, que en 10 años ella se ve básicamente tomando la posición de su mamá.
¿Cuál de todas?
In 10 years, I don't really see myself in anything, but if I have to choose, in my opinion, I see myself as like a mayor. Okay. I want to not change some things in Greenfield, but like, you know, change, like, get ideas from the community to you know, just, if they give me an idea, like, I would be like, yeah, I'll see, like, what we could do. Not, like, put it aside and stuff, you know, like, actually think about it, work it out with, like, my colleagues and stuff. Like, that's what I want to be when I, in 10 years.
A ver, voy a traducir lo que dijo, que ella no está segura, no tiene una idea muy clara, pero que tal vez en 10 años va a ser alcaldesa. Y que ella lo que quiere es escuchar a la gente y trabajar en equipo para resolver problemas.
In 10 years I see myself voting for these people.
Megan se ve votando por ellas en 10 años. Por ellos también.
So that's actually a really great question. I've always been a person that's never really, you know, set myself on one thing. I wanted to be a firefighter when I was smaller, then I wanted to chase tornadoes in Oklahoma for one. I was all over the place, but where do I see myself in 10 years? I don't know where I'll be at in 10 years, but for a fact I do know I will continue to give my time towards pursuing change, pursuing justice, activism. That's where my heart is at. So in 10 años, ¿dónde me veo yo? ¿Dónde estaré trabajando? No sé, siempre he sido una persona que soy, no puedo decidir yo, quería ser bombero, después quería ser cazatormentas en Oklahoma, pero lo que sí me veo yo haciendo en 10 años es, no importa donde esté trabajando, el activismo siempre va a ser algo que yo voy a querer dedicar mi tiempo.
Actually, Yaneli has given me so many ideas of what I should be in 10 years, and what, one of them was like, an attorney, or like another one was there.
Kelly, PA secretary.
Kelly, PA secretary. And like a coordinator and organizer. And all of those things have really been in my mind. I do want to pursue at least one of those. Yaneli me ha dado muchas, muchas opciones, como ser abogada, este, ser organizadora de una organización, trabajar para el gobierno como secretaria en Sacramento. Este, pero sí, la verdad, sí me gustaría perseguir alguno de esas de esas carreras, porque también uniéndome a la organización Save Back Save Schools me ha abierto muchas puertas y me ha inspirado a seguir adelante para alzar mi voz para mi comunidad, y yo quiero lo mejor para mi comunidad, y es por eso que me gustaría perseguir alguna de esas carreras.
Se lo dejo a los jóvenes, pero también voy a votar por ellos, los voy a apoyar y seguir en la lucha. I'll leave that for the youth, but obviously I will still be in la lucha.
Um,
Well, for me, I think I would also pursue what Yaneli has been pursuing. Maybe
mayor, councilwoman.
Maybe being mayor. Or also being an organizer for future leaders of change. I do kind of see myself taking that on, as like how Yaneli has taken on with SAS. And yeah.
Ella también se ve en 10 años quizá ocupando una oficina donde es concejal en su ciudad, o también haciéndose cargo del grupo de líderes líderes del futuro para el cambio, porque ella le inspira mucho el trabajo de Yaneli y ella ve que ella podría hacer lo mismo con el grupo de jóvenes. Muy bien.
My long-term goal is to hopefully become a professor at Cal State Monterey Bay, because that's where I'm an alum from, before getting my master's. To just like create a hub where like people can just do great journalism and can help inspire like these amazing like filmmakers were able to create these beautiful films of just what they had. And I hope to hopefully become a professor, a tenure professor at CCMB, and being able to continue doing that and really reinvesting in our community. So.
Emma se ve a sí misma en 10 años siendo profesora en la Universidad de Monterrey, CSUMB en Monterrey, y a ella le apasiona el periodismo porque ella ve el trabajo que hicieron estos jóvenes con tan pocos recursos y hay tanto por hacer en esta área de contar nuestras historias a partir de periodismo y documentales, que esto es lo que ella quiere hacer y ojalá lo cumpla.
In 10 years, I'll be celebrating 10 years of being a SAS member. But yeah, I kind of joined what Megan and Mami were saying, kind of leave that to the youth. But I will definitely be there voting for you all, cheering on you, and buying tickets to your films, all of that stuff, all those dreams and multiple, whatever tornado thing you decide to face, I'll be rooting from the sidelines. Bueno, una cosa es que en 10 años, bueno, 11 en realidad, voy a celebrar mi aniversario de 10, 11 años de ser miembro de SAS, orgullosamente. Y pues igual me uno a lo que decía Megan y Noemí, se lo dejo a los jóvenes, pero pues voy a estar votando también por todos, viendo sus pelis, apoyando sus proyectos, cualquier tornado que vayan a seguir, los apoyo de lejos, pero los apoyo.
So in 10 years I see myself having a PhD and sleeping in the trees in Santa Cruz. That is my dream. All jokes aside, in 10 years I see myself taking Assembly Member Connelly's chair and being up there sponsoring the future bills to come.
Gobernador de California.
Gobernador. Sí. Quiere ser profesor con un doctorado en la Universidad de Santa Cruz y también ocupar el cargo de legislador que vimos en uno de los documentales, que es el que fue el autor de la legislación que usted, por la que ustedes pelearon, ¿verdad? Muy bien. Votamos por ti.
Más que nada.
¿Se puede o no se puede?
Sí, se puede. Y eso, en vez de pregunta, digo que me siento bien orgulloso de todos estos muchachos que los he visto desde que comenzamos aquí, que comencé con Yaneli, aunque yo tengo ya 6 años o 7 años en el movimiento este de los pesticidas, pero de cuando comenzó con el grupo de estos jovencitos, pues sí, lo he mirado. Y pues mira, ahí está toda la madera. Así es de que en 10 años ustedes pueden hacer lo que ustedes quieran hacer, porque tienen la madera, la tienen. Así es de que sí se puede y adelante.
¿Cómo se llama?
Juan Manuel Morán, de la Unión de Campesinos.
Oh, wow, muy bien, muchas gracias por estar aquí. Él lo que compartió, oh, in English, right? Okay,
He said that he's super proud to see these young people here in the front. He has been in the fight for many, many years and started working with Gianelli 6 years ago. And it's incredible to see what you have been able to accomplish all these years, in only 6 years. And he's really excited about your future.
Yeah. Y también me siento muy orgulloso de Gianelli porque ella apenas andaba en la high school y comenzó a ir a mi oficina y ella también allí me apoyó. Y ahora ella es la que me jala para donde quiera. Así es de que también un aplauso grande para Gianelli porque ella es la que ha hecho todo esto. Y me siento orgulloso también de ella porque la he mirado crecer también desde, como digo, desde la high school. Ya andaba en el movimiento ahí con nosotros y yo creo que aprendió algo porque mira qué bien organizado los tiene. Y las muchachas que quieren ser organizadores y quieren organizadoras, vayan a aplicar ahí a la oficina de nosotros. Gracias.
Well, I'm going to shout out to Nayeli, Gianelli, because she started working when she was connecting with him, with the union, when she was a high school student. And it's really, really powerful and incredible that she has continued and has mobilized all the youth. And he's really, really excited to work with Gianelli and he's really proud of her work. Y ahora la invitamos a pasar, por favor, al frente.
Yo quería decir también que aquí hay otras personas que están participaron en las películas y queríamos reconocerles también.
Yes, absolutely.
Bueno, hay muchísima gente, pero pues también Isabel, no sé dónde estás, pero
Isabel, I see her.
Isabel, levanta tu mano.
¿Dónde está la mamita?
Para Isabel, para Alex también.
What is the future for these films? Where else can we see these films? Where are they going in the future? En el futuro, ¿qué pasa con estas películas? ¿Cuándo podrían otras personas verlos?
Excelente pregunta.
¡Pedías!
Gianelli, pues, we have a plan.
Sí, bueno, pues ahorita estamos, gracias pues, a una colaboración que estamos haciendo con el Festival de Watsonville. Este es solo el principio. Pero vamos a ir otra vez con el apoyo de tanto de la beca del Central Coast Creative Corp y de Arts Council of Monterrey. Estamos coordinando una campaña regional para hacer programas similares, como hacer pues colaborar con organizaciones en diversos lugares del Valle Central, sobre todo, y de la Costa Central. En áreas de California y también pues por otra ruta también festivales de cine y que la película viaje y hacer tal vez materiales para que la gente pueda, si no puede asistir o no podemos organizar una en su ciudad, que ellos puedan tener un programa y tener como herramientas para poder tener un evento en su casa, en su comunidad, en su iglesia, etcétera. So we're very, very, very fortunate to be. This is just the beginning of the partnership with the Watsonville Film Festival. Also, thanks to the California Central Coast Creative Corp grant and the Arts Council Monterey. But the plan is for us to start finding strategic partners in the region, especially Central Valley and Central Coast, so that we can have this similar events and screenings, Q&As that we can, you know, travel to, or that the students can travel to, and the emerging filmmakers can travel to and spread the word. But also submit the film to festivals, and so they can travel and again spread the word. And we're also going to create like a viewing kit, viewing guide, so that educators can screen this projects in their classrooms, or if we cannot bring a film somewhere, or actually organize it in person, then at least people can have the films and then have a discussion guide, so they can like invite their communities, their church groups, or anyone, any place where they can activate people, even if we're not there.
Cool. Yeah, so that's the plan, and this is just the beginning. Thank you so much for being here. This has been so exciting and inspiring. And we wish you the best with your film. This is just the beginning, and we know you'll be inspiring so many communities into action, because that's what we need, right? Muchísimas gracias a todos por estar aquí.
emergentes y las cineastas profesionales.